Right here.
I just a couple of announcements for the holiday season. We have the holiday radio, the station again, running 121netradio.com has holiday hits running, and every 45 minutes there's an announcement trying to get the populations out there listening to us to donate to us. We'll see if it works, see if it doesn't, but if you and your family would like to listen, you can go directly to the website at the camp website, and when you get to the front page, it's going to go on. You'll hear it play right there, but there's also other ways and links to do it from that page where you can listen. So just wanted to let you know that. And number two, once again, we're doing a broadcast worldwide right now. So I haven't checked to see how many viewers we have, but we are broadcasting, and the service will be on the YouTube channel in a day or two once I get it finalized, so you can watch it again if you want, having been here to see all this. So,
yeah.
Thank you, and Merry Christmas.
Not nervous. I forgot about the audience.
Worldwide.
We are having a potluck lunch today at the same location as last year. We have Nancy Samuelson's community. I don't have the authority, Nancy. Oh, you should put them right there. I don't have the address, but if somebody needs directions, they can ask me.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you for arranging that for us, too. At the potluck, there will also be raffle prizes available for the fabulous 44-item listing of prizes that can be won by, really, a $1 ticket. We do sell them in increments of $10, so you get a whole booklet for $10. And I just found this out last night. If you buy 11 booklets, or I mean, if you buy 10 booklets, you get a free one. So you get 11. So buy 10, get one free. And I love bargains. So anyway, those are going to be available at the public and also at Gage Marine starting at 4 o'clock when we gather for the boat ride. Gage has generously donated their boat ride. I was there last night selling tickets, and a lot of those rides are sold out. I mean, so we're really fortunate to be able to get it. And the people were talking about how lovely it really is. David, you went on it already, right?
Last week.
What'd you think?
I thought it was really nice. They play with the kids. They the displays along the way give a little story for each one. I think because it's their first year, they're doing a great job. Next year, it'll be better.
Yeah, cool, very cool. I'm excited to go too. So like I said, that boat ride takes off at 4:30. So be there before 4. There's a lineup inside the showroom of Gage Marine. It does say Santa Claus on the door. I don't know, maybe some have lockers or strollers, but when you go in that door that says Santa Claus, it's all stairs. So you would have to go in through the restaurant and down and around. I think there's either a ramp or an elevator, they told me inside, but I was concerned because of the stairs. But there is access. So if, as you're facing the building, it says Santa Claus, you go to the left. Alrighty. That's from 4, they sell tickets today from 4 to 7, and every Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Wednesday through Sunday, our boat ride at 4:30, and it'll be all our camp people, as far as I know, it'll just be people from camp on this boat, so we'll have a good time. And there's also, I noticed the bartender in the lobby there, even more suspect of people, so that, so I'm going to say, very much. And on the boat, good.
And again, we're, you know, since it's our private trip for our group, we don't have to charge the $24 that they normally charge for the cruise. We're just charging $10, and we'll be collecting that as we line up to go out on the boat. So
$10.
Yep. That all that money goes directly to camp. So.
And we get all of that.
Yep.
All that ticket sales for today's boat ride. Any other things I read in this? Shall we begin our worship to our Lord and Savior today in word and song? Our opening song, again, we'll start the ends of the shoes. And our opening song is Come On You Faithful, number 75. Sing loud. I'm so sorry. Yes, sir. A lot of grace. Yes, Terry is his writer from Lynn Press, which is Nancy's church, and we're so grateful.
Thank you. I'm really glad.
The dog sled
to press down. Yeah, if I have to stay here the rest of the winter, I'll just do it. Please stand and sing it. Come on, baby.
Come let us adore. rejoice and be glad.
And I used to do this one, the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
You may be seated. Let's go to our time of celebration for celebrations and concerns. And so we're glad to have you all here. I appreciate being here. This is your fifth year for Christmas celebration together, my second. So I'm becoming like old hat around here. People need to get out of a rut and get someone else here, but please don't, because I like doing this. Greetings from Lynn Presbyterian Church. We just completed our second Sunday of Advent service a few minutes ago, and glad to get over here for this. This is the second Sunday of Advent, and it's the Sunday called Peace. If you've ever been in a church that celebrates those Advent Sundays, you know those words, hope, peace, joy, and love. Anyway, let's do our joys and concerns. I know you people have some, and I will pray for them. Please raise your hand or shout out any particular prayer that you
have. I have a concern, unfortunately.
Okay.
So a long time friend who I know through doing theater died yesterday.
Oh.
His 85th birthday.
Bless her heart.
So, you know, her to his wife and kids.
85 years young. We had a prayer request to church today. Carl Rathman's mother died out in Oregon. And she was 103. Years young. Yes.
Prayers for my sister Susan, who was having surgery just before Christmas.
Susan, surgery before Christmas. I think I'm certain.
Celebrate niece's birthday, Sarah.
Yeah, Sarah. Birthday.
I have some friends struggling with cancer right now, so.
Male or female?
It's Don and Maureen and Jeff.
Oh, Don and Maureen and Jeff.
A joy. My daughter Jenna is turning 18 this week.
You kick her out?
You touch her.
Amen. You started with joy, so that's good. I mean, some people could say, my kid finally turned 18.
That's
right. And I'm concerned that the world is not ready for that. Ministry that Norman Barr has. So it's good. The word gets out and lives are changed. So
I would like to add to what Kimberly just said and really kind of go forth and use the motto of choose kind that we've adopted. So I think that's something
so
we can all
important.
Act as our mission.
Sometimes we feel like we can't have impact on the world. Especially after this crazy year in America where we feel things are out of our hands in some ways, but they're not. You know, every individual makes a difference. It's true, it's kind of hokey, but it's hokey can be true. So keep making a difference in your ministry. Choose kind, you say.
Yes.
Yeah. I'd also like to state that within Norman Barr Camp, let's all be kind and loving to each other.
Thank You're a man after my own heart.
I love you.
I appreciate it. You give me so many chances to preach some more because, you know, churches, that's what they're supposed to be. And then when you get involved in churches, how many have ever been deeply involved in churches? Are they always kind to each other?
No.
We're doing this Christ-like message in their not at our church, but in some, the Lutherans. Yeah, they're. Yes.
Blessing.
Amen. All right. Happy birthday, Dad.
The joy of Christmas.
The joy of Christmas. I love it. I'm never going to. gonna be anything but a kid at Christmas. Sorry about that. All the decorations up at my house. Had the grandkids over this weekend. I do it just for them. I don't do it because I like it. No, wrong. It's just so much fun to see them running around. I have like 30 different nativity sets. Most of them are kid-oriented, so they can take them apart and put them back together. So we'll talk a little bit about that today, too. Thank you all for your prayers. Let's join together in prayer, and I'll end it with the Lord's Prayer. You guys use sins and sin against us. Remember that part. If I say debts, forgive me, but just keep going with sins. You guys are sinners. I'm a debtor. Let's pray. Lord our God, we do give you thanks. We pray on behalf of this gathered people, this congregation, this kingdom, because we are a part of your large kingdom, your universal church. We pray in the name of Jesus for all of those who are listed today, some joys, some concerns. Sometimes we pray for cancer. Sometimes we celebrate birthdays. Some days there are upcoming surgeries. Some days we say goodbye to loved ones. Either way, all of our prayers are in the hands of Jesus, and we are confident when we approach you, O Lord, that our prayers will be heard. Thank you for this season of Advent and Christmas, when we celebrate those words of peace and hope and joy and love. Thank you that we can gather together under your star, which shows us the way to peace. These are our prayers. We lift them up in Christ's name, and we say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Are we doing all the verses of It Came Upon the Midnight Clear? Yes. I think we should. Take note of the words. You only sing it once a year, unless your pastor won't do it at all, which is a shame, because It Came Upon the Midnight Clear as a profound hymn. Christmas carol. Read the words. We stand and sing. No, sing the words. It came upon the midnight clear.
To touch their hearts.
through the cloven skies. I remember as a kid going, what does that mean? You know, still throw the, through the cloven skies means the heavens, the skies split open that night and the angels came through. Because cloven is like cloven hoof. You know, y'all know this, and I'm just telling you this, and you're saying, we've known this for a long time, preacher. That's what it means, right? Cloven skies, so as a kid, I was always confused about that. And also, when I was younger, I had no idea what, and ye beneath life's crushing load, because life wasn't a crushing load when I was a kid. But read that verse to yourself, and it's about you and me, whose life becomes heavy burdens at times, with forms bending low, and I'm getting there. Aren't you getting there? Who toil along the climbing way with painful steps and slow. First time I really noticed that verse was when I had back surgery. Anyway, it says, look now, for the golden years will come. I'd like to read for you the familiar passage that is often used. Some preachers save this for Christmas Eve, but I don't. I use Advent to introduce characters of the Nativity at my church and to sing Christmas songs from November 27th all the way to Christmas, because I'm a child at heart and I don't want to wait to Christmas Eve to sing three songs when there are about 50 really good Christmas songs, right? So this passage is from Luke 2, and you will recognize it. You might not recognize the translation. I'm using one, the translation is called The Voice. Not the TV show The Voice. You guys watch the TV show The Voice with Blake Shelton or whatever the dude's name is, right? I don't watch it, so I don't know. And this is The Voice. It's a translation that Greek and Hebrew scholars, such as myself, handed over the translation to poets, and the poets handed over to scriptwriters, and the scriptwriters handed it over to musicians, and together they came up with a translation that comes alive, and they call it The Voice. So here it is, Luke chapter 2, selected verses. Listen to the word of God in this translation. Now around the time of Elizabeth's pregnancy, and John's birth, the emperor in Rome, Caesar Augustus, required everyone in the Roman Empire to participate in a massive census. This was the first census, since Quirinius had become governor of that area called Syria. Each person had to go to his or her ancestral city to be counted. Mary's fiancé's name was Joseph, from Nazareth in Galilee. He had to participate in the census the same way everyone else did, and because he was a descendant of King David, his ancestral city was Bethlehem, David's birthplace. Mary, who was now late in her pregnancy that the messenger Gabriel had predicted, went with Joseph. And while in Bethlehem, she went into labor and gave birth to his firstborn son. She wrapped the baby in a blanket, laid him in a feeding trough, because the inn had no room for them. Mary pondered all these events, treasuring each memory in her heart. And here it ends our reading from God's Word for today. During Advent, as I said, we bring characters to the Nativity. How many of you have little Nativity creches, mangers that you set up at home? I do that. I collect them. I love them. I have kids ones. I have adult ones that you shouldn't really touch, so I keep grandkids away, right? But not too many of those. What constitutes a nativity is my first question. The reason I like to see them from all over the world is to see how people interpret them and who they put in the nativity. This year, last Sunday, I brought people you don't usually bring in early. I brought the shepherds, and then I brought the magi, or the wise men, and I put them together in the nativity for the congregation, and I said, those people came seeking hope. Today, Mary and Joseph come seeking peace. This is the Sunday of peace. You have a nativity up here. Who's in it?
Joseph.
You could call him Joseph, but during my children's sermon, I said to the kids, this is Mary, and who's that? And they said, her husband. They don't even need a name. He's just Joseph. Joseph is the reason they go to Bethlehem. Joseph is the one who has the ancestral home in Bethlehem, right? King David. It's through Joseph that Jesus can claim to be the king that replaces King David, and then the king for the whole world. Mostly we pay attention to and Jesus. I have determined in my collection of nativities that they range in size. People bring nativities in church for me so I can demonstrate them. Some of them have like 27 characters. Because there's no rule about how many sheep are there, how many cows, right? Cows? Moose? No moose? Giraffes? Well, that's Noah's Ark. We don't know. But I've determined that really a nativity consists of two characters. Jesus and Mary. It really should be three, though, because this Sunday we're reminded that Joseph has the ancestry. So a nativity, the best nativity starts with one, two, and three. Now you've got in here, you've got a cow, you've got some sheep, you can't see them because of the greenery. And that's fine. But you also have who that comes to the nativity?
Wise
guys, yeah, wise guys from the east, who are called seers or astrologers or magi. Magi is the word that we use that comes from magic. They weren't magic makers, they were astrologers. Very intelligent, very well educated, very rich. How many were there?
Three.
Bible doesn't say. Never says how many magi. They brought three gifts. That's why you always see three magi. One of them's got gold. One of them's got frankincense, and myrrh, and they have symbolic meanings. Who else is there? Shepherds, because we know the story talks about that. We didn't get too into this. And who else?
Angels.
That's right. All of them. That's the nativity. Animals, angels, shepherds, Mary, Joseph, Jesus, wise guys. Yeah. And I think the story is told so that we can find, you know this, we can find ourselves at the nativity. I have a great picture I show in church every year. And in the, I have the nativity scene, right? And in the nativity scene is Darth Vader, a dinosaur, Charlie Brown, stormtroopers, regular human beings, wise guys, shepherds. What does that mean? It means everybody comes to the nativity. In our church we have Sue Larkin, you guys know Sue Larkin from the lake? She's a lake person. She collects in France these characters called Santones, and they're handmade little characters, and they come from all walks of life. And in our church around our fireplace, like over there, we have all year round, we have all these Santone characters. They're beautiful. And I took them down for Christmas Advent this year because I wanted to put nativities, and then she explained to me that Santones are characters made by hand by people in southern France, and every character, whether they're carrying a lamp or a pot or something to farm with, every character is on their way to the nativity. So she told me you don't have to take them down at Christmas because every one of them all year long is on them. That's how the tradition got started. The tradition that brings every character, even you, even me. And when I say character, I mean characters. To the nativity. Today, we welcome, at least I did, Mary and Joseph. Come seeking peace. Inner peace, outer peace, world peace. Peace on earth? Amen?
Amen.
Peace on earth? Come to the nativity. It's the only place you're going to find it. It's the first place you'll find it. And everything else will work out. Let's pray. Lord our God, we give you thanks and praise and joy and glory and honor. And we thank you for the peace that passes all understanding that comes from you. This is our prayer. Amen. Scripture tells us it's more blessed to give than it is to receive. So your blessing is at hand. Did you know that? You get to give. This is the offertory time. I assume you're going to play something that will inspire large amounts of money to be given. And do I give these to somebody? Please give your tithes and offerings to God.
Thank you. Huh?
I'm gonna get your best side as you walk.
Ready?
Ready?
Sacrificial life for the sake of others in this world. It's in Christ's name that we pray. Amen. Remain standing. Get out your hymnals if you need them. 83, Joy to the World. I want to see some joy out there. Joy to the World.
Someone will explain why the tree is upside down.
You gotta get your
to me.